these social networks are really not that social. drove down the street today, thinking it's really unfair. I mean, look where we are. Get them up. Sunrise, waking up to some life. Bank balance is low, but I ain't really stressing funds right. I'm just trying to have a little fun, like soak it in and let my mind develop in all the sunlight. It's natural to want right, so we just keep it low key. Everything copacetic, called into my office job, cause when I'm there, no one gets it. Blinded by the desk, shielded with no windows. See, when they got us there, we function on a different tempo, but it's cool. I'll just skip the day, screw the rules. They've been on me usual. Casual days are suitable for low attendance. Thou shalt not work, that's my amendment. Will not work your shit a job for low pay and no pension. My environment is pristine. Been this way since 16. Driving lean like Christine. My city's like a big dream. And I'm just here sipping beers, trying to stay conscious. Avoiding all the gossip in the high school nonsense. Get in the zone, running on a little bit of limits and loans. Getting up the minute that I'm hearing the phone, cause it's a beautiful day and I'ma let it unfold. Cool breeze, new schemes, blue jeans, and a whole lot of loose teens. Who fiend to act all grown up when they still just true green? This is the place that has come to be really my true home. The city is sun and the humidity comes, but it ain't nothing to be really going juiced on. Vibe with me, this time has got its limits and they do run out. So soak it in and let's begin appreciating what it's about. I mean, cause you gotta really look around you. If it all ends tomorrow, you be happy where you're at. What's it like to live in paradise? 80-something, man, it's nice. Culture all around you, all you like, and you just find it all so typical.
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 What's it like to see the women walk the night? Nines and tens, the type, do everything you can to be polite, and still you find it all so typical.
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 In a land where the sun came up and it never went back down. And the women we around at the front page raising, they never play background. Got my Corona and Patron and two solo cups. I've never given any, so I guess I probably owe some fucks. I speed along, through this new scheme I'm on. She said to leave him on, the nights can be deceiving, huh? We hit the deuce, we hit up Tootsies and the KOD. Locals are pegged to be celebs, it feels like fame to me. And how this came to be is so amazing. We just up and play the scene, get up and save your dream. If you ever wanna get up in the middle of an all-star vacancy, this is your chance to live it up. So come and claim it slick, or you could keep up with the dumb shit and be called the plaintiff quick. Your honor, I'm guilty cause I wanna stay out with the people. Honor, bendables and marijuana. Wanna wander with the champions, it comes with the work. It's typical to tip the scales, they call it heaven on earth. So if you thinking of relocating, this place is so gracious. The people fly, no need to cry, it's all an oasis. Hop on the bus and hear it every single night. I tell them where I'm coming from and they all asking what it's like. They like, what's it like to live in paradise? 80-something, man, it's nice. Culture all around you, all you like, and you just find it all so typical.
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 What's it like to see the women walk the night? Nines and tens, the type, do everything you can to be polite, and still you find it all so typical.
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 Everything I'm seeing here is quite typical. It's easiest to reach the places of beauty and appreciation in your subconscious mind first. It takes a much more focused mind to go down a level into the realm of lust, rejection, and alienation. We must go deeper. We have much more to explore.
Yeah. What is up, everybody? It's your boy, Pigskin Pete. Happy Friday to everybody. I hope everybody had a great week. I really do. What is going on over here? What is this? Hold on. Let's stop this right here. Yes, unpair that. Yes. Professional over here. The number to call in, if you want to call in, to the most underrated college football call-in show on all of YouTube. What is going on over here? I got multiple devices. 864-207-4522. It's not the best. That's Mark Rogers. It's not the longest running. That's Uncle Lou. But the most underrated college football call-in show on all of YouTube right here. If you want to call in, the number to call in is 864-207-4522. We can talk about anything that you want to talk about. Literally. Well, I take that back. There are definitely some things we can't talk about because YouTube won't allow it. That has nothing to do with me, though. As far as I'm concerned, we can talk about anything, but I don't make the rules around here. So, what's in the news? Georgia and Alabama supposedly paying players. I talked about that at nauseam. Don't want to talk about that anymore. Today, or last night, rather. Derion Kendrick, former cornerback, former wide receiver, former player of the Clemson Tigers, arrested on gun and drug charges 3 days, a short 3 days after he got released from the team. Sad situation. Former five-star guy. And by the way, he played great at Clemson, too. He played great. Obviously has some issues that he needs to take care of. It'd be one thing if he got caught with what happened last night while he was on Clemson's watch. The fact that he got released 3 days ago and now he is in trouble doesn't surprise me, and it also worries me. It also worries me. I'm not talking about Clemson. Clemson's fine. I'm talking about him as a person. He's clearly in a dark place, and I'm not here to judge the guy. Right? What is he, 20 years old? 21? I don't know what he is. He's a junior or senior before he got released. And I remember being that age. This is the reason you don't see me, making videos about how college kids screwing up this and that on a regular basis. Because I was there, right? I made some bad decisions. We all did, didn't we? I made some bad decisions. Very bad decisions at 20 years old. So I'm certainly not one to judge. I just hope he's okay. That's all. I would imagine it's probably pretty difficult to get released. You know, you're one of the best players in the country coming out of high school. Go to one of the best programs. You know, at the time he came to Clemson, they were, on top of the mountain. They were the best team in college football when he came there. And a short 2 or 3 years later, you're released. A week later, you're in handcuffs for gun and drug charges. So I would imagine mentally he's not in a very good place. So I'm just praying for him as a person. Forget football. As a person. So anyway, what else is coming up? Oh, the NFL draft is heating up. It's heating up big time. Like a gas stove. All kinds of shit going on in free agency. The NFL draft's coming up. In honor of the NFL draft, I have started the contest for every single Friday night show that I do, the Friday night live call-in show. The highest donator through Super Chat will be entered into the contest to win $100. $100 from Pigskin Pete. This has been going on for about the past 4 weeks. Have several entries. You will pick the order that the quarterbacks will be taken in the 2021 NFL draft. And let's see. The quarterbacks are Trevor Lawrence, Mac Jones, Justin Fields, Trey Lance, who is moving up many people's boards very quickly,
by the way.
Kyle Trask and Zach Wilson. In no particular order. The person that gets it closest to that order or gets it completely correct in the exact order will win $100 from Pigskin Pete. Just email me your PayPal and I will PayPal you it immediately. That's right. And right now it's wide open. I mean, it couldn't be more wide open. And I see people in the chat posting the order of the quarterbacks that they think they're going to go in. Well, get in the contest then. Win $100. Pretty simple. Pretty simple. All right, let's see who's in the chat here, and then we'll get right to the phone calls, which is the reason for the show. 864-207-4522. If you're on hold, just hold on for another 2 minutes. And I'll get right to you. I promise. Matt Dummett's in the house. Clemson Carson is here. Tiger Paw Craven. Tiger Paw Craven, I believe he's in the contest already. I do believe that. Go Tigers, says yo. And when he says go, he doesn't mean go. He means gawk. Gawk. LSU people can't spell. They spell go with an X. SEC dog. Pigskin Pete and Tater Nation. Yes, thank you, sir. George! George is here. John Kelly. Rowdy Rocker, Bama Buddy, DeGoat Watson. DeGoat Watson is the DeGoat, by the way, just in case you were wondering. That's been cleared up. Raj! Raj is here. Jesse J. Yes. Creature. Creature. This is a new one. Yo, Pete, how are you feeling about the next chapter of Clemson football and how will it be different than the past teams? Well, the past is a long time. I mean, we have over 100 years of past, right? So that's a very, very in-depth question. What's this guy's name? Creature, call in and we can talk about that. Yeah, it'll take a while. Ray Finkel's house, or as I like to call him, Ray Finkel's bedroom, which is way more creepy than Ray Finkel's house. Traveling Fools. Narcissist live in the ATL. Hold on.
It does, because like I said, I say it from experience. I I've been used before, and it's no fun being friend zoned, and it's no fun being played. It's no fun liking a woman knowing that she's dicking around with somebody else, and it's no fun inviting a woman out somewhere for the weekend on a camping trip.
Flag on the play.
Romantic feelings, and she knows it.
Flag on the play.
That night, she's having sex with some dude in a tent where you're at.
Listen to this here. Listen to this.
That happened to me. This woman that I liked for a year or so, I invited her to hang out with my friends at a camping trip in the mountains in 2009 or 10, was it? And she wound up just basically, when we got there, walking around, basically ignoring me. And I drove up there, by the way, with her and in my car. And she wound up making out and fucking some dude, in the same tent that I was sleeping in.
The same tent.
I was like, yeah, that is tough. That was the worst feeling I ever had. I mean, I've had feelings.
All right, look, I can do this all night. I can listen to Sleeta talk about some girl fucking some guy in a tent all night. I'm going to move on, though. DeGoat Watson, I think I already said, A.S. After Olave dusted him, he lost control of everything, he says. What? Look, A.S., you're a regular around here. I know that. Sir? Another one that needs to call in. Clearly. Tiger Nation, brother for life. What's up, brother? The sports experts here. Michael Hogg is here. Dylan Deloney sent a $2 super chat. He's in for tonight. As a matter of fact, hold on. Okay. Shit. Hold on. Okay, good. I'm back now. Dylan Deloney entered into the contest. I guess that might be it. I don't know. Ballard's here. DeGoat Watson. $10 super chat. Thank you. Still waiting for the Panthers to get DeGoat Watson. Yeah. So I heard that so Clemson had their pro day yesterday, and a bunch of teams are having their pro days right now. So all 32 teams. Listen to this guy. And by the way, it doesn't matter who you're a fan of. This is important to know. How many FCS teams out there? Right, the FCS is full of, Citadel, Charleston Southern. I mean, those are just some of the local ones where I live. I mean, you know who's in the FCS. Look, now I understand North Dakota State is a FCS powerhouse, right? But it's still the FCS. All 32 teams had scouts at the North Dakota State Pro Day today. All 32. There's not another FCS team in all of America that had all 32 NFL scout teams show up to watch one of their players. Period. Period. What they did for Trey Lance, though. So that's all you need to know about him. He will clearly go in the first round. The question is, where will he go? A lot of rumors. So Carolina's right in the sweet spot, right? Carolina's picking 8th overall. And, they'll be in the mix probably for a Mac Jones. Definitely for a Trey Lance. Maybe for a Zach Wilson. Probably not. Consensus is Carolina is going after a quarterback. They need one. They need one bad. Really bad. But that tells you all you need to know about Trey Lance. The fact that all 32 teams will show up to watch his pro day. All right, let's see who's in the... let's see who's on the phone lines here. What's up, your own Peete? Hello? Take your time. No problem. I got nothing but time over here. Just trying to run a call-in show. No big deal. No big deal at all. Thank you. What's up, y'all, with Peete?
What up, Peete? How are you doing?
Hey, what's up, man? How you doing?
Good. How are you?
I'm amazing and fantastic. Yeah, I'm just over here trying to run a call-in show, but people don't know how to talk on the phone, apparently.
Well, I thought that was me last time on the line, but I never got a beeping thing, but it's good to know that it's me now.
What? That was you?
No, that wasn't me at all. I was confused, though. I didn't know what was going on as well.
You weren't near as confused as I was, believe me. So what's up, man? What can I do for you?
So I'm like you. I hope Derion Kendrick gets the help he needs, because I can understand a bit of how mental health can get you down sometimes. I do understand what it's like to have low mental health.
Right.
Yeah. And then another update for you. I have cut down on teams to root for.
So how many teams before you cut down were you rooting for?
Remember y'all joked about me having like 20, but now I only have like one.
You went from 20 to one?
Something like that, because I thought you said I had 20.
I didn't say you had 20.
Oh.
Did I? I say that?
I remember people trolling me. I don't know if you said that, but I remember people on the Collins show trolling me about it last year.
Oh, okay. So who's the one then? Who have you narrowed it down to?
In the heart. This is from the heart only. Tennessee. I'm back into them.
There you go.
On the outside, I'm Alabama, just because I go there.
Whoa! You know, look, sir. You went from Tennessee to Alabama. This is alarming. So which one is it? You can't choose both. I'm not allowing it.
I'm not. Believe me, I like Tennessee way more, but that's a secret.
But you're an Alabama student.
Yeah, but there are some Alabama students that are Tennessee fans, though, believe it or not.
Wow, this is tough.
Alabama's a national school, so that's how I know, because I've seen some people.
Yeah. I don't really know what to say about that other than good luck with that. I mean, do you wear Tennessee stuff like to class?
No.
Or how does this work?
No.
I got to know. This is fascinating.
Not at all. I wouldn't do that. Believe me, I'm scared about it. So.
I believe you. I believe you.
Yeah. What is your next topic? What is anything else you'd like to talk about?
Well, you called me. So, I mean,
yeah.
It's whatever you want to talk about.
Well, I do have to ask you this, though.
Yeah.
What do you think about the Saints cap space situation right now, and who do you think they should try to draft? What should they go after?
The Saints? I don't know enough about the Saints to make a logical point on that, other than, is Drew Brees retiring? Because as far as I know, he hasn't retired yet.
Me personally, even if he doesn't retire,
well, that matters. That matters.
I do think the Saints should move on.
If he retires, though, then they need to draft a quarterback, right?
Or
get one in free agency. But I don't really know who's available.
Yeah. I was thinking they should consider Cam Newton, but that's out the window.
Yeah, Cam Newton re-signed with the Patriots today, from what I saw.
Yeah.
So, yeah, he's out the door. The Saints, out of all years in the NFL, out of the past, whatever, 10 or 15 years, there is more teams that need a quarterback than any other year that I can remember. So there's like at least like nine teams. There's like not like a third of the league needs a quarterback, right? So
I'd say so.
Yeah, at least.
I mean,
now,
they need people to throw downfield these days to win. So
Now, whether they get those quarterbacks through the draft or through free agency or whatever, trades, you know, is yet to be seen. But I would say if the Saints, if Drew Brees retires, because let's just go ahead and lay this out here. If Drew Brees is not retiring and plans on coming back for one more year, he's the starter. He's not coming back to sit on the bench, right? It's not happening. He's Drew Brees.
Well, I mean, I do think he would start, but I have seen some times where, like, you saw with Eli Manning, I do think he got benched, like, at some point.
Yeah, and that might be what happens, too. But the point is, look, the Saints need to be looking for the future. Is Jameis Winston the future of the Saints? No.
I'd keep it a candidate.
Look, he might be a Band-Aid for a year or two. He's not the future. So.
Yeah, I still want him on the roster.
Yeah, I mean, look, he might be the best backup quarterback in all the NFL, no doubt about it. But he's not, Jameis Winston's not winning a Super Bowl. Sorry, it's just not happening. Might not even win the South.
Understand. I mean, I also see that scenario very well, but I'm gonna remain optimistic. And even if this is a rebuilding team for my team, I'm fine with that as well.
Yes. Right.
Anyways, I'm going to let you get some other callers.
Yes. Thank you, sir. You're amazing and fantastic. Thank you for calling in. Believe me, I appreciate it. What's up? You're on with Peete.
Hey, what's up, Pigskin Peete? It's Ballard Sports Media.
Ballard Sports Media. What's up, buddy?
Not much, man. Just wanted to call in, talk some college football like we always do on here. And I'll ask you real quick, did you have a great time at the Slob Olympics, sir?
I couldn't have had a better time.
Awesome.
Yeah. No, it was amazing.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, as far as real quick, I mean.
Until Sleeta showed up. Once Sleeta showed up, it wasn't amazing anymore. I'm just kidding.
That caught me and everybody by surprise.
Oh, really? They caught you by surprise? Even though I told you for 4 months it was going to happen, you still surprised you, huh?
Look, I want nothing to do with the Slob Olympics, my dude, okay?
Yeah. I'm just kidding. Look, he was fine. I'm not going to stop ragging on him about it. That's not going to happen. So he can prepare for that for the next 12 months. Until he actually shows up for the competition, I'm going to rag on him about it. That's all there is to it.
Yeah, I got you. I mean, he knew y'all were in Atlanta, which is where he is, and he couldn't stay away or nothing. But, yeah, that's great that y'all had a great time and everything. But I wanted to talk some NFL draft stuff with you.
Uh-oh, here we go. All right.
Do what?
Yes. No, go ahead.
Oh, yeah. So all the mock drafts I'm seeing, and I know you kind of touched base on this a little bit with your previous caller, but I see a lot of mock drafts. You're a Panthers fan, if I'm not mistaken, right?
Yes, I am.
So, I mean, I see a lot of them say Trey Lance to the Panthers. I mean, would you be okay with that pick? Do you think they should trade up and get someone like Fields? Like, what do you think of? I mean, I've even seen a guy like Mac Jones or whatever going that high for him. I don't know, but you know, if there's a quarterback that they need, like, who are you taking? I mean, obviously, I mean, nobody's Jaguars are straight up taking Trevor Lawrence. So, I mean, that's out of the question for you, sir.
Well, I've seen a bunch of mock drafts that do have Mac Jones going to the Panthers. I have mixed feelings on that. I don't know. I don't know about him. I don't know.
Yeah.
Zach Wilson, Trey, all of them, Mac Jones, Trey Lance, Zach Wilson, all three of those guys, I guess. I mean, it's they're all, to me, not as big of a sure thing as Trevor is, and obviously, like you just said, Trevor's going to Jacksonville, so we can just go ahead and eliminate him. Justin Fields, same way. I mean, look, I'll root for any of the guys that get drafted there.
Right.
What I really want them to do, though, and this is a total pie in the sky homer take, and I know that, so just go mm-hmm. ahead and save me the typing bullshit about how I'm a homer. I want to see them trade for Watson, yeah. even if it means giving up C-Mac.
McCaffrey?
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
That's just me. But
Yeah.
If they don't end up making that happen, I mean, I don't know if as far as I know, the Texans are not trading Watson. I mean, they pretty much made that clear. Mark Ingram, former Alabama running back, just signed with the Texans for a 1-year deal.
Yeah, I saw that.
And he said the reason he went there is because he wants to play with Watson. That's what he said. So, I mean, that's not coming from me. So I would have to imagine, just based on that statement alone, that Mark Ingram has had a conversation with Deshaun Watson, and Watson's probably look, man, they ain't trading me, dude. So you can come here. I'll be here. You know what I'm saying?
What were you saying?
No, I don't think they're trading Watson. I used to think they were, and maybe they still will. We'll see. But they've been very clear. We're not trading Watson, and that's it. Like, so, I mean, until I see something different, I'm going to go ahead and assume that Deshaun Watson's going to be Houston Texan next year, period. So.
Oh, yeah, I would fully agree with that. I mean, there's no reason for them to trade Watson. I mean, the problem with the Texans.
Well, there is a reason.
Isn't Watson.
No, okay. You're right. But there is a reason. And the reason is because it's a media nightmare. If you have a player that is one of the top 5 or 10 biggest stars in all of the NFL, mm-hmm. and that Deshaun Watson is that, and they are running around talking about how they don't want to play for you anymore, that is a reason to trade him. I mean, look, it's a PR nightmare. Let's put it this way. Imagine if they don't trade Watson and then they go 2-14, or they start out the season 6-2 or 2-6, not mm-hmm. 6-2. And they're bad.
Yeah.
The PR nightmare behind that is going to be, every single press conference, every single commercial on ESPN, everything about everything as far as your organization is concerned is going to be about you have this guy who doesn't want to play for you. And that is a PR nightmare.
Right.
So if you are the Texans and you're smart and you know the guy doesn't want to play for you and he's being vocal about it in the media, the best thing you can do is get rid of him and his huge contract and get mm-hmm. something in return for it. If you can get two first rounders plus Christian McCaffrey, if you can get two first rounders plus whoever, I mean, plug another player into place on the level of Christian McCaffrey, do it.
Right.
Do it.
Yeah, and what I don't understand, a couple months ago, I was seeing news about Watson for Tua. I mean, are the Dolphins already thinking about getting rid of Tua? I mean, he sparked the offense late in the season.
Yeah.
That was all ridiculous.
I don't think that's going to happen. I'm a Tua fan.
Yeah.
Believe me, I've already gotten to enough arguments with people talking about Tua as a bust. Didn't Tua have a winning record as a starter? Isn't he 4-2?
I don't know what it was.
He's like 4-2, I think.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, this guy played, six games or something? And they're already saying he's a bust. I mean, give me a break. Where did they draft him? Number 4 overall or something like that? I mean, they drafted him high.
Yeah.
No, they're not. That's not happening.
I mean, I can understand if you want. I mean, I can understand if you want to try to get a guy like Watson. And in order to do that, the Texans are going to try to get Tua. But, I mean, I just. There's a risk reward factor in all that, you know?
Yeah. The Dolphins aren't trading for Watson. Anybody who's saying that, just go ahead and look, it's not happening. Period.
Yeah. And then real quick, I'm sure you got other callers or whatever, but
I do.
What is one thing you're looking for out of Clemson this spring that you hope to see get better for next season?
Defense, which I already know is going to be the strength of the team this coming season. So I'm not worried about that at all. Look, Clemson's going to be amazing and fantastic this year. Anybody who doesn't think it so is not paying attention to college football. Thank you, Ballard Sports Media. You're the man, sir. What's up, your own Peete?
Hey, Peete, it's Nate.
Nate?
Yes.
The great?
Don't be late.
Don't be late?
Yes.
A.K.A.?
Nate Kingston.
A.K.A. Nate Kingston. You got more names than Prince. It won't be long before Nate turns his name into a symbol like Prince did. He won't be anything. He won't be Nate the Great. He'll just be some symbol on YouTube. We all have that to look forward to. Yeah. What's up, Nate?
Not much, man. Last night I watched Michigan versus Penn State in this playoff. Michigan won. Big. 47-31, I think.
Are you talking about basketball?
Yeah.
What are you talking about? 47-31.
No. Uncle Lou's disappointment playoffs.
Are you talking about
like a
simulated video game?
Yep.
Oh, all right. I didn't know. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, but I just wanted to let you know that Michigan won against Penn State. So Penn State lost, so they move on to the finals for the disappointing playoffs. So Michigan's not disappointing.
Very disappointing.
Anyway, did you see the news that NCAA had change the rules for overtime for football, I think.
Hold on. Now, this is something that interests me. No, I did not hear this. So, can you tell me what I missed?
Well, I didn't see the details, but I just saw a notification on the phone. Something had to do with overtimes that NCAA changed. So I don't know the details, but I'm just letting you know. But
this definitely interests me.
I'm hoping it's not that bad, but if it's like a little fix-up, I'm okay with that. But, what the hell? I'm scared.
Huh? What's going on here?
Blocks up.
You okay, buddy?
It's the echo dot.
What? Nate.
Here.
Nate's killing the show here. Believe me, I kill the show fast enough. I don't need Nate to do it for me. So thank you, Nate, for the call. He was talking about echo dots, and I don't know what was going on there. What's up, your own Peete?
Hey, Peete, J Dub calling from Iowa.
J Dub, what's up, J Dub?
Hey, listen.
Yes.
Does the sun rise in the east in South Carolina?
In South Carolina, yes, it does. Yes, absolutely.
Okay. Are circles round?
No. Circles are circles. Balls are round.
Is blue a color?
I would say so, yes. These seem like trick questions, okay. Jeff. What are you getting at here?
Did you have a good time at the Slob Olympics?
Yes, I did. That, without a doubt. Okay. I don't know if circles around, but I did have a good time at the Slob Olympics. Yes, definitely.
Yeah. Now that I've got Ballard's obvious answered questions out of the way, I would just like to say that I'm calling on behalf of the entire graduating class of 1989 from the University of Alabama, who I'm going to speak on behalf of and completely disavow the jackass who called in earlier
Yeah.
And can't make up his mind who the hell to root for, even though he's sitting in classes in Tuscaloosa.
Have you ever heard such a thing before? You know what's funny about him? Shout out to him, by the way. Not him, but the guy who called in earlier. He called me during the off season and said, I'm a Tennessee fan, but I'm about to go to Alabama. And so I said, this is a conundrum, right? This could happen to me. This could happen to anybody, right? So I'm a lifelong Clemson guy, like since I'm in diapers young. But if one of my sons goes to South Carolina or Georgia or Florida or wherever, Tennessee, like, I kind of got to root for my son, right? Like, that's how you become a two-teamer, I think. But if I'm a kid, I'm going to say kid loosely, right? A young man, let's call him a young man. If I'm a young man and I go to school somewhere myself, I'm pretty sure that's my school, right? I mean, would you disagree with that?
Yeah.
Right.
Not at all.
Okay.
See, I became an Alabama fan, even though I grew up in Springfield, Illinois, because my parents divorced right after I got out of elementary school, and my father moved to a home that was right across the street from a former assistant coach for Bear Bryant and was three blocks from Alabama's practice facility. So it was like a 10 and 11 year old. I'm riding my bike.
A former assistant coach from Bear Bryant was three blocks away.
Yeah. The man's name was Dude Hennessy. He recruited Joe Namath. He recruited Ray Perkins. Another guy you may have heard of named Kim Stabler. Dude was my dad's across the street neighbor for years and years and years.
Yeah.
But anyway, I digress. That's how I became a Bama fan, and I ended up going to school there.
Well, that matters.
But had I followed a lot of my classmates and said gone to Eastern Illinois or Southern Illinois, I would have still liked Alabama, but I would have been a diehard Panther fan, a diehard Saluki fan. I mean, it's where you go to school. That's
sure.
Where you give your heart.
Yeah, sure.
And I'm not saying you can't root for Clemson if you didn't go to Clemson. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is if you went to Clemson and you don't root and you're not rooting for Clemson, something's wrong.
Yeah, right. Yeah, no, I'm with you. I got you.
Well, hey, I just couldn't let that go. I just couldn't let that go. And I wanted to make sure, Peete, that I know you've only said it about 700 times, but I just wanted to give you one more chance to make sure everybody knew you had a good time with the Slav Olympics.
Oh, the Slav Olympics was amazing and fantastic. And why weren't you there? Are you coming next year?
I am absolutely coming
next year. All right, good. I'm holding you to that. I've got a list. I've got a list, and it's at least three people long so far that didn't come that said they're coming next year. So I'm holding all of you personally responsible for your decisions. If you say you're coming, you better come. That's the way this is working now.
Well, you know.
And the repercussions are terrible if you don't. Way worse than what happened with Slita.
Well, yeah. When they killed spring sports and then they didn't have a minor league baseball season, I lost about half of my salary in 2010 or 2020, about half of the money I make. So it became a little bit of an issue to fly down to Atlanta. But
sure. Yeah.
All things being equal, I'll see you all in Tennessee. No way I miss it.
Great. Looking forward to seeing you there. And I'm sure I'll talk to you a million times between now and then. J-Dub, everybody, he had an issue with the fan that called in that said he was an Alabama student, but he still loved Tennessee more. J-Dub is officially the fan police.
Warning, fan police en route.
What's up, your own Peete?
Peete, sir, how are you?
Amazing and fantastic. How are you doing?
Better now, off work.
Yeah. So you are amazing.
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, I'm amazing anyway, but
You are. You're indeed amazing. I can contest to that.
First of all, I'd like to shout out that 89 Alabama class. How about that Sugar Bowl?
Uh-oh. Here we go.
I can't not mess with Jeff. Point number two, that Saints fan that called in, and this statement's pretty much going to go to the entire NFC South. Give it up for the next few years. There's no chance.
Uh-oh. So the Buccaneers win a Super Bowl out of nowhere, and then all of a sudden Slim Shady Kane says, for the next 2 years, no chance. No chance, he says.
Oh, they've already extended Tom Brady's contract. So.
Oh, great. So what? So now instead of being 89 years old, he'll be 90. Good job. Can't wait to see what he looks like next year.
No, I mean, I feel good going into this year because they pretty much locked up everybody they were worried about losing.
So you have a history of losing bets to me. So you want to go ahead and make another bet? you might like this bet.
Well, before we get into that, I have a question because remember we had a second bet for the combine, but since they're not doing the combine, are we going to count pro days?
Yeah, except for that Lawrence didn't run the 40 for his pro day. It was about Lawrence. Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't know if Clemson already had their pro day.
No, they had it yesterday, except for Lawrence. He didn't participate in it. That's the reason he did that thing early with, throwing the ball. He didn't run a 40. So I mean, if he didn't run the 40, there's no way we can settle the bet. I said better than a 4.55. That was the bet.
Yeah.
And you said worse than a 4.55, but he didn't do it. So we'll never know. So, you know.
We'll just null that one. Okay. Well, what do you have in mind then?
I'm going to say that the Tampa Bay does not win the South. In 2021 season.
I mean, I'd probably agree with you. They didn't need to win the South this past year and they still won the Super Bowl.
Well, so you, well, all right. I mean, I'm confused. Do you think they're going to win the South or not?
I think
going to win the South, but you think they're going to win another Super Bowl. I mean, what kind of thinking is that?
I think they probably will win the South. I do think Drew Brees is done. I think Jameis Winston, they need to go ahead and hit him with the franchise tag and get it over with.
Will they pay him in crab legs? So let me ask you, do you want to make a bet or not? Because if I don't make the bet,
you make a bet on the NFC South. That's fine.
All right. I'm not betting on which team will win. I'm just saying it won't be Tampa Bay. So you're saying it will be Tampa Bay.
Yeah, you get the field, I get Tampa.
Okay.
Bay.
So what's the payout? What are we betting?
Well, since we didn't get to go on the Lawrence bet, do you want to make up that bottle of Maker's Mark this time?
Okay. I like this. I like where this is heading. You know what the best thing about it? Do you know what the best thing about our bets are, Slim?
What's that?
We like, in other words, like it, normally if you bet, let's say you bet somebody $100 that so-and-so is going to beat so-and-so and that's the bet, right? And then so you lose the bet, you pay the guy $100, you never see him again. Or the $100 again. When we bet, we bet things that we can drink together. It's a win-win situation. There is no loser in this thing. All right? So
really,
if you bet me a bottle of Maker's Mark, I'll just hold it. If I lose, right, I'll just hold the bottle of Maker's Mark until the next Slob Olympics. I'll meet you there, and we'll drink it together.
Sounds like a plan.
So these are the best. Anybody else want to make these kind of bets with me? These are the best kind of bets. There's no loser.
got to just put a little thought into it. It's not hard. Everybody makes out in the end.
Yes. Share the wealth. So everybody just heard it here live on the air on what's today's date? The 11th? 12th? What is it? I don't even know what day it is.
12. That's 12.
Sorry, I'm coughing. March the 12th, 2021, Slim Shady Canes and Pigskin Pete have made an official bet that, well, I'm saying that the Buccaneers will not win the NFC South this season. He's saying that they will, and the official bet is a bottle of Maker's Mark. We have moved up from a bottle of Jack to a bottle of Maker's Mark. This is getting very serious here. Very serious.
Have to pull out the Glenlivet before long.
Next thing you know, it'll be Courvoisier.
Uh-oh.
Which I don't drink, so I'm not betting that. But anyway, you get the point.
Now, just so you know, since we've already made the bet, I probably should have mentioned this before. They've already been in contact with Richard Sherman and Larry Fitzgerald, who are both in free agency.
Oh, wow. 280-year. If you add their ages together, it's over 80. Well, I'm supposed to be scared about that.
All they got
to
do, all
Larry Fitzgerald and Richard Sherman.
Once as they ever were.
Jesus Christ. So what? Hey. So between Tom Brady, Larry Fitzgerald, and Richard Sherman, you've got Social Security only 2 years away. I'm supposed to be scared about that.
And Ndamukong Suh.
Oh my God. This is like an old folks' home. You know what they say? All old people move to Tampa to retire. Yeah, it's true. It's especially if you still play in the NFL. You move there to retire.
But you know what? All they have to be is as good once as they ever were.
Yeah, well, that was lightning in a bottle, sir. Look, it's not happening again. Oh, sorry. Sorry to tell you.
Now, most of the team around them's young enough. There's really not much to worry about.
Rob Gronkowski's running around selling CBD pills like he's fucking Cheech and Chong. Look, man, Antonio Brown is one phone call away from being back in jail again. I mean, look, this is a disaster waiting to happen.
No, it's not. Like I said,
yes, it is.
They'll have O.J. Howard back next year.
Oh.
So Gronk's never supposed to be the starter anyway.
Well.
And,
right.
Did you see the way Cameron Brate caught that trophy when Tom Brady chucked it? They can throw him in the game. He'll be okay.
Right. All right. Yeah. So, Maker's Mark. Not only will Tampa Bay not win another Super Bowl back-to-back, they won't even win the NFC South. That's the bet. Everybody's heard it. It's here. It's on record. There is no running from it now, right?
Oh, that's fine.
Right.
Because I've got a feeling Tom Brady's going for the one thing, actually the two things he hasn't done in his career, and I think that's what he's playing for at this point.
What? What are those two things?
An undefeated season and a three-peat.
Interesting.
Not calling it, not saying it's going to happen, but I think that's what he's playing for.
Yeah. No. it's hard. Look, when's the last time somebody won back-to-back Super Bowls? It might have been him, right? Was that in the early 2000s?
It was.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, it was early 2000. Well, mid 2000. It was around 2007.
Yes. Right. I'm winning this bet.
I'm sure we'll have a Miami Clemson bet before the year's over.
I wouldn't be surprised if Tampa Bay went like 9-7. I'm just saying. All right. Thank you, Slim Shady Canes. What's up? You're on with Pete.
Hey, Pete. Michael, how you doing, sir?
Michael, what's up, buddy?
that much. The one thing I was going to say when you talk about college is I'm a diehard Purdue fan, but my degree is from Indiana University. But to expound what Nate was trying to do, talk about earlier, there's a rule I think the NCAA is either considering or passed. But you know how in the third overtime you have to go for 2 points?
Yes.
In the third overtime?
Right.
What he was trying to say is I think they got it to where they're talking about doing it starting the second overtime. That's what he was trying to say.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I didn't hear that until somebody said it in the chat.
Yeah, but isn't that going to make the games longer, though?
Well,
or do you think it might speed it up?
I mean, I kind of like the NFL overtime better. There's some things in college I like better than the NFL as far as rules go. And there's some things I like in the NFL that are better as far as college rules go. Now, you can pick and choose whatever, you know, scenario you want. Here's my thing. Just forget about all that. I think they should be uniform. I don't understand why there's two different sets of rules for the NFL and college football. I really don't. I don't understand the point of it. Mm-hmm. I mean, I understand they're two different you know, entities and all that, and they make their own rules, and there's a long history of all that. But look, it's 2021. It's not 1930 anymore. Look, can we make it uniform? Yeah. And why, for the love of God, why is there a different size football in college than in the pros? And they go, oh, well, because, you know, the pros are bigger and they got bigger hands. No. Look.
Yep.
I've got both in my own house. I have a college football size ball and an NFL size football, and my hands aren't NFL size, and I'm damn sure not no NFL player. I can throw them pretty much just the same. I don't understand what the point of that is. I don't understand what the different overtime rules are, the different rules on a catch, you name it. Down the line, let's make them the same. It's confusing and stupid, isn't it?
Yep.
Yes. Yeah. I know it is. Of course it is.
I'm sure your boys play baseball, right?
I'm mad over here. Go ahead.
Your boys play baseball, right?
Yes.
That's just like with baseball. Why is there like so many rules? Why can't they just go with one set of rules there?
Right.
Instead of having rules for college, rules for pros, and rules for high school. That's what I'm saying. All right, sir.
Yes.
I said my two cents for tonight.
Yeah, thank you for calling.
Have a great weekend.
Yeah. Thank you. Hey, listen, you're amazing and fantastic for calling in and getting me mad about nothing. That's how I know it's time to get off of here. I'm getting mad about the difference between college and NFL rules. That is definitely a sign that it's time to get off. But that shit does get under my skin, period. Always has. I think the winner of the contest tonight was, who was it? DeGoat Watson. It was DeGoat Watson sent a $10 super chat. Dylan Deloney sent one as well. Thank you, sir. DeGoat Watson, let me know the order of the quarterbacks and the where they will be drafted. What order? So we have, unofficially, I mean, there's more players than this being drafted, but we're making the assumption that these are the first six going to be taken, and that might be wrong, too, which means nobody will win, or maybe whoever the closest will still win. Trevor Lawrence, Mac Jones, Justin Fields, Trey Lance, Kyle Trask, and Zach Wilson. What order, put in the chat, do you believe that those guys will be drafted in? If you win, you will win $100 from Pigskin Pete. Tax-free. Oh, Wilkie just sent $5. Thank you, Wilkie said, how do you get in the contest? Well, you get in the contest by being the highest donator every Friday night. And the highest donator right now is still DeGoat Watson with $10. If DeGoat Watson's not in here, there he is. He's asking for help. Now, I will allow this. I mean, most contests would say no help allowed. I'm allowing it. Go ahead. Y'all help him out. Here we go. Trevor Lawrence. Y'all help him out. Trevor Lawrence. Mac Jones. Justin Fields. Trey Lance. Kyle Trask. And Zach Wilson. Out of those six people, put them in order. Uh-oh, Wilkie's coming in with the steal. You see this? Wilkie said, the show's not over yet. I'm about to outbid you to go. Watson, look at this. Look, the rules are rules are rules. I didn't put a time limit on this thing. And Wilkie has, he's moved his way up there. He outbid you. It is what it is. Wilkie, what's your pick? Sorry to go watch, but thank you. I mean, hey. Look, I'll take both of you. Look, seriously. You can if it's going to be a difference between $11 and $10 and the contest has been over for a few minutes. Tiger Nation with $10. This is going to be this is an orgy of contestants all at $10. Look, just give all of you guys give me your picks. You're all entered. Thank you. Traveling Fools is trying to shake it up even more. Says someone go for $12. No, don't. Stop it. Stop it. Look, all these guys are amazing and fantastic. They're getting in the contest. They're contributing to the channel. But none of them are giving me their picks, though. That's what I need. I need your picks. I mean, if you want to win the $100, I need your picks. Look, all right, here's what I'm going to do. Tiger Nation's saying his picks are whatever Watson said. You can't pick the same. You got to pick your own. This has to be fair and unbiased as possible. Here's what I'll do. You guys just look, they're in the description of the video, there's an email address, freedomgrady@gmail.com. Email me your picks. I'll write them down. This will last all night if I don't do that. So the three guys that just donated, all three of you, email me your picks. Six quarterbacks. What order will they be in? Email it to me. I'll write it down. You'll be in the contest. It's pretty much that simple. Thank you all the people that called in tonight. It's been an amazing and fantastic show. It's been an amazing and fantastic week. Looking forward to Monday at 10 p.m. with my man Uncle Lou on the Lunch Money Show, the show about nothing. Also at noon on my channel, College Football Coast to Coast with my man Mark Rogers TV. That's it. That's it. Nothing left to say other than thank you. I love all of you. And I'll see you very soon. Have a great weekend. Pigskin Pete is checking.